Hare Krishna. So welcome all of you for our this Gurukul session. And today, being a Tuesday, we have a story. There is a special story. Before we start, let us all recite the prayers. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshuronmilita Yena Gurave Namaha. Shri Chaitanya Mano Vishtam Stapitam Vayam Rupam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamsha Shri Rupam Sagrajata Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Pada Lalita Shri Shakanda Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prashtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Namaste Deve Saraswati Devi Narvani Bhajani Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paapishatari Namo Mahamurudanna Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gauratvishe Namaha हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका राधा कांत नमोस्तुते तप्त कांत गौरांग हरे वृंद शुभानुदे नमामि प्रणम कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा राम राम हरे कृष्णा So today we had a little time change because we also had our programs, our classes. So it became little time was different. So we started a little late. So Divesh Prabhu, are you there?
Yeah, Prabhu.
Yeah. Please take attendance, okay? Because our
yeah, Prabhu. Every time taking Prabhu.
Yeah. Yes. Because our Prabhu. He's having some exams, so he's not coming nowadays, but afterwards.
Yeah, okay, Prabhu, I am taking every day.
Yeah, yes. Thank you. So, let us begin our today's story about, before we go for the story, there is interesting shloka in Bhagavad Gita. All the shlokas are interesting. They all teach us very wonderful lessons for our life, right? But then we should be knowing the lessons of that for our life, correct? So otherwise then we'll not be able to learn much, we'll not be able to change our life much, correct? So we have this interesting shloka in the 16th chapter. It comes, ya shastram yudhim utsrujya vartate kamakarata nasa siddhim avapnotim na sukham na param gatim, right? So what is the translation? He who discards, means one who doesn't follow the scriptures, one who doesn't follow the scriptural injunctions, right? And then acts according to his own whims, means whatever he likes, he does, he doesn't follow. Then what happens? He will neither get happiness, nor he will get the supreme destination. Or to be simple to understand this shloka, right? Sometimes, not sometimes, every time our parents, right? Our elders and all, they keep on telling us how we should act, how we should behave, correct? But then if you don't listen to them, like let's say for a small child,
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Small kid, if he wants to put a hand into the fire, because fire looks very, very attractive, isn't it? Colors are there, yellow colors and things. And if one who doesn't know about the nature of the fire, that small child, baby, 1 year or 2 year, he wants to put a hand into the fire, it will burn. So father says, don't put hand, mother says, don't put, but he demands, right? But then if he goes on his own, and puts the finger into the fire, what will happen? What will happen to him? Will it burn?
It will burn.
it will obviously burn.
Burning sensation.
Yeah, whether he knows or doesn't know, fire will burn. Fire will burn, correct? Fire will cause problem to his finger. But imagine if he listens to his father and mother, he follows, right? Then he will be saved. Oh yes, it is called as a fire. We should not put hand into it. It will cause injury to us, right? But then after experience, he understands, right? So we should not allow to learn by the experience. It is English, there is a saying. Experience is a best way of learning, and fool learns by no other way. Right. So intelligent student, intelligent child, he will hear from his parents, he will hear from the teachers, he will hear the words of Krishna in Bhagavad Gita, right? He will hear what the saintly personalities like Srila Prabhupada and all they are telling us in the teachings of their books, correct? So if you follow them, then we'll get the happiness in present life and the future life both. Future life also will get a better destination, right? Like let's say in a school you study nicely, then surely you will get a good score in the present year, and the future also you will get a lot of opportunity because you studied very nicely. So the same way, we follow our life properly by following instructions, right? Guidance of our elders, our superiors. We listen to them, not to become independent or not to become our own way. That's called as whimsical, whims, right? So then naturally we'll fall into the problem. But if we follow them, then surely we'll make our life more better, right? And that's why there is a very, very interesting story of Lord Krishna and one sweeper. Okay, so you're able to see Krishna standing. So in the temples, Krishna will be always standing in the form of deity. So what used to happen, there was one sweeper in the temple. Okay, you know the sweeper? Sweeper, they will clean the temples, right? They will clean the houses, they are called as a sweeper. So there was one sweeper in the temple also, who used to come every day, used to sweep the temple. And he used to see so many people are coming every day to take darshan of the Lord. Day and night they used to come, okay? Then that sweeper saw, oh, Krishna, he is standing so much. Yeah, please keep it. Sound is coming. Yeah. So Krishna is, that sweeper is thinking, oh, Krishna has to stand. You are able to see? Krishna is standing. Yeah. Ganesh Prabhu, please keep.
Yeah, Prabhu.
Please keep mute. Yeah, if you have to speak anything, then unmute. Otherwise, maintain the mute. Some noises are coming from behind. So deities are standing in the temple giving Ashirvad or nice. Krishna plays the flute. Here the deity is like in a posture of standing. So that sweeper was thinking, oh, God has to stand so long every day. He might be tired, isn't it? Standing so long, like a stand-up punishment. The trees are having a stand-up punishment, right? Because they did not behave nicely in the human life. They got the body of a tree. They're standing in the outside cold or everything, right? So like that, sweeper is thinking, oh, yes, like in the class, if we also don't listen, teacher will remove us out, stand outside or stand up on the bench, right? So those who listens, they're not given the punishment. So sweeper was thinking, oh, it's like a kind of a very troublesome for Krishna to stand so long. So you know what he did? He told Krishna, you are standing so long, so I'll help you. I can stand in your position. You are just giving Ashirvad to the people. So I can also stand like this, giving Ashirvads and all. I can also continue. So God felt, oh, good, good, nice. Very good idea. And then the Krishna told him, okay, one condition. You stand on my position, but with one condition. And what is that? Krishna told, don't speak anything. Don't do anything. Just stand and give Ashirvad. Even if you see anything wrong or right, don't speak anything. Just give Ashirvad. Sweeper said, that's all. I'll not speak anything. I'll just stand. Then what happens? Let us watch the video. All of you like to watch the video.
Prabhuji, one back.
No, Prabhuji.
Yeah, I would like to watch the video.
I want to watch the video, Prabhuji.
Yes. I'll show you the video now.
Yeah, Prabhuji.
So what happens to that sweeper?
Yeah, we saw the PDF of this.
No, that is different.
Yes, Prabhuji, value education.
Trust God.
Acha, okay. Some of you might have seen, some of you may not. Let us see once again. It's very interesting.
Prabhuji will watch the pain, Prabhuji, pick or not.
You are able to see the screen?
Yeah, Prabhu.
Yeah, Prabhuji.
Yeah, Prabhu.
Yes, Prabhu, I am able to see.
Temple of Lord Krishna. There was a sweeper who was very sincere and devoted.
Every Prabhu, can you increase voice a little bit? Of
the Lord. Yeah, yeah, I'll explain in between because volume is maximum here. Water is there, it's a peak, my volume is peak. So, as I said beginning, the sweeper was there, you saw, in the temple. And he saw so many people are coming for darshan, okay? So, I'll explain meanwhile.
We can share the sound.
Sorry? Share the sound, it's come same only. There is no difference.
Yeah, okay, Prabhu.
He thought to himself, the Lord is standing all the time giving darshan. He must be feeling very tired. Oh Lord, your feet must be aching. I want to help you.
So you understood? You are able to understand here, right? He comes to Krishna and says, oh God.
Prabhu, no, the voice is clear, Prabhu. Volume is clear. It is high.
Yeah, Prabhu. No, I'll just repeat once again in case if some of you are not able to. So he comes and says, Krishna, your legs might be aching. So let me help you out.
At least for one day, can I take your place so that
So he says, at least for one day, I'll take your place so that you can relax. Okay, at least for one day.
You can have some rest.
Thank you, my dear. It is very nice of you. And I don't mind taking a break. But how will you take my place?
It's simple. You change me to look like you and change yourself to look like me.
Okay.
So Krishna asked, how will you take? Then he said, you make me like you and you become like me. So simple, we'll be able to do like that. So let us see.
I'll transform you like myself. But there is one condition.
One condition, as I said. Now Krishna is going to speak that condition, okay?
You must just stand here like me, smile at everyone and give blessings. Never interfere with anything and do not say anything. Just watch everything and be a witness.
Understood, na? Condition? Don't say anything. Just watch and witness. That's all. Just give blessings. Don't speak anything. Just stand and watch. Okay? So, ready?
The sweeper agreed to this and exchanged places with his lord. The next day, a rich man came to pray.
Oh Lord, please bless me. My business should go on well.
While leaving the temple, the rich man forgot to take his briefcase, which was full of money.
So understood, rich man comes. He says, please bless me. My business becomes successful. But what happened? What happened?
He forgot his briefcase.
Yeah. He lost money.
So the poor man comes after that, okay? So I think all of you are understanding now. I'll not speak in between. Afterwards, we'll do this. Yeah. So I'll just take a little bit behind and once again we'll see.
While leaving the temple, the rich man forgot to take his briefcase, which was full of money. Just then, a poor man came into the temple.
Oh Lord, please accept this coin, as this is all I can afford. Bless me to be engaged in your service always. My family is hungry and my heart is leaking. I need some help from you.
When he opened his eyes, he saw the briefcase left behind by the rich man. The poor man thanked the Lord for his kindness and generosity and took the briefcase. At that point, a sailor walked in.
Oh Lord, I'm going on a long trip. Please bless me so that I have a safe journey.
Just then, the rich man came in with the police.
There, he is the thief who stole my briefcase full of money.
Hey! Did you think you could run away after robbing this gentleman? Come on, tell me, where's the money?
I did not steal anything, sir. I don't have any money with me.
Then you must have given it to your friend who must have run away by now. Come with us to the police station.
Dear Lord, you know I am innocent. Why am I being punished then?
Thank you, Krishna. You are the one who helped us catch this thief.
The sweeper in the form of the deity could no longer tolerate the situation. He had to speak up now to save the sailor.
Stop! You're making a mistake. It was not this sailor who took the money. It was a poor man who came here before him.
Who is that speaking?
Here, I am God speaking.
This person is not only a thief but also a clever cheat. He is tricking us into thinking that the idol is speaking. Arrest him, quick!
The sailor was arrested and taken away. The sweeper felt very sad. In the evening, Krishna returned to the temple.
My dear, how was the day?
I thought it would be easy, Krishna, but it was difficult. I tried to do a good thing, but man does not seem to have actual faith in God at all.
The sweeper then told Krishna about the happenings of the day and how a sailor had been unfairly punished for the crime of the poor man.
Oh dear, why did you not stick to the plan? Don't you have faith in me? Do you think that I do not understand the hearts of all those who come here? The rich man had money which he had got by cheating someone. It does not belong to him. On the other hand, the single coin offered by the poor man was the only coin he had. But he gave it to me with full faith. The sailor might not have done anything wrong, but if he had gone in the ship today, he would have died because of bad weather. Instead, he is alive and safe now in the jail. Soon the police will apologize to him and release him.
I did not know all this.
I have a good plan for everyone's life. But because your faith in me is shaky, you try to do things on your own. Don't do that. Just trust me.
For everything that we see around us, God has a plan. We need to trust His wisdom and accept His will.
Hare Krishna. So, was the story clear? All of you understood?
Yeah, Prabhu.
Anyone who did not understood can raise their hands. Let me see how many of you not understood. Yeah.
Understood, okay. Prabhu.
Yeah, correct. Very simple.
You all understood, Prabhu.
Yeah, correct. Very nice. Thank you. So you saw? So how come God knows everything and God has a plan for everyone? How is it possible? Yes, you are learning our other.
Because God is in every, because God is in everywhere's heart, in the form of super soul.
Perfect. Because God is present in everyone's heart as a super soul internally, so He knows our internal thoughts and as well as external.
Excuse me, Prabhuji.
Yeah. Wait. We'll take the question, just 2 minutes, okay? So God knows internally as a super soul. He's not only seeing the action externally from the top, but he knows our intentions also, okay? So you saw, that's the rich man came, brought a lot of money and asked for the blessings. So externally, somebody may think, oh nice, he's a nice man, good man, going to God and praying. But then God was knowing what God said, what Krishna said about rich man.
Prabhu, he had got
stolen money.
The money what he is earning is from a wrong way. So that's why he forgot the money. So somehow he will get, his reactions will be cleaned. But if he uses that money, then he may get do wrong things again more and more. Correct? So God knows not only externally, but he knows the internally as well. And that's why poor man's situation also. Poor man gave only 1 rupee, but then that was the only one what he was having. Any example anyone remember from scripture, like the poor man giving 1 rupee money, similar to that?
Yes, Prabhu. In one story, Krishna gives some grains to a mango seller. And in return, he gives gold necklaces and all.
Yeah, any other example?
Prabhu. Bali Maharaj also, Prabhu.
Yeah, Bali Maharaj.
He gave everything.
I'm asking one example of the poor man especially. Bali Maharaj, of course, that's correct. That's also good.
Sudama.
Sudama,
Everyone knows. Correct. Sudama story, I'm sure all of you knowing, right? So God doesn't see only how much we are giving to God, but God also sees how much we are holding it back with us. Right? Let's say if that rich man was earning so much money, but he was giving God only 10 rupees. But poor man has nothing, but he gave only 1 rupee. So externally, it may look like 10 rupees or more, or that rich man is giving more and poor man is giving less. But relatively, in absolute sense, poor man is actually giving more, because how much he had, proportional to that, he's giving more. Whereas a rich man, he had more, but he's giving very less to the God. Correct? So God doesn't see only externally how much we give, but God also sees how much we're holding back with us. Right? So Srila Prabhupada, he gave his whole life, his whole existence to Krishna. Correct? So you see how Krishna reciprocated with Prabhupada. Whereas that rich man was supposed to get punishment, so Krishna made his money forget. And then poor man, he's giving his best, he wanted some help, so God arranged that money to go to poor man. And that sailor, he somehow went to the police station. The reason was what? If he would have gone on his boat, he would have got drowned into the water. So the God wanted to delay his journey. So that's why police came and took him to the police station. Right? So sometime in our life also, sometime some wrong thing happens, some bad things comes. We may think, why God is doing like this to me and all. But we should have a faith. We should know that Krishna knows the better plan for our life. So maybe he want me to learn good lessons. Maybe he want to become more better in my life. Maybe he want to make me, I should not be lazy in my life. He may be wanting me to work hard. Correct?
Prabhu?
We should be knowing these lessons for our life. Correct? So then only we'll have a good faith on Krishna. And that faith, if you have with Krishna, then Krishna will do best situation for our life. He will bring out more and more better things for our life. But if one doesn't have faith on Krishna, if one doesn't follow the instruction of Krishna, that sweeper was told, just stand here, don't speak anything, just give the ashirvad, just do the blessings. But he could not, he spoke out. Correct? So it should not be like that. And especially for us, Krishna is directly not speaking in the sense how that sweeper was get audience with the Krishna. But Krishna is speaking to us through his books, correct? Krishna has given Bhagavad Gita. Krishna has given his pure devotees like Srila Prabhupada, and he has given the books for all of us to study and learn. Krishna has given us the good parents at the home, isn't it? So if you follow their good advice, if you chant every day, lead a pure lifestyle, and then follow what our parents are telling us to study nicely, lead a good habits and all, then surely Krishna will bring out the best situation for our life, right? And that's why the lesson of the story, God knows the best, right? And Krishna has a justice, and Krishna has a special plan for everyone. We should have a faith on Krishna. So we should do our best, and then rest Krishna will bring out whatever is required for our life. Okay? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we'll take question answers also, 5 minutes. Let us end with Vaishnava Pranam, those who want to leave. वांछा कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः अनंतकोटि वैष्णव वृंद की जय श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय थैंक यू हरे कृष्ण
थैंक यू प्रभु